Hey guys, what's happening? This is Jay DeMayo. I'm the head strength and conditioning coach for basketball at the University of Richmond. I am also the head strength and conditioning coach for Nova Aquatics LLC here in Richmond, Virginia. And what I'm probably most known for in the strength and conditioning world is my work with CVASPs, the Central Virginia Sport Performance Seminar. Today, I wanted to put a lecture in the community site that's actually going to be two parts. And this is going to kind of fill in a lot of the questions and answers that we get when it comes to some of the means and methods and ideas that we utilize to formulate the programming with what we do with some of our athletes. And that really revolves around the idea of minimal dose programming. You know, this is something that it can cross into all areas when it comes to the physical preparation spectrum, whether it be rehabilitation, return to play, or, your general physical preparation. And it's something that I think that a lot of people have these misconceptions about or these fears about or these ideas that may just be a little bit off because we get a lot of the same questions repeatedly when it comes to this. So I figured this would be a great platform to not only just put these answers that I have to some of these questions out there, but also to lead to an open discussion and hopefully help us find a better way to do all this stuff, because I know I sure don't have all the answers. So hopefully some people can check me and help me out a bit here. You know, obviously the biggest thing, if you've ever seen me talk, is understanding that the first step to eliminating these misconceptions is to recognize that the entire strength and conditioning paradigm or spectrum, whatever we want to call it, is based upon the same principles, right? Like these principles, no matter what the aspect is, are all the same. When we are looking at things, general adaptation syndrome, the SAID principle, things like that, all are all encompassing. The way you adapt to stress, the way your body handles stress, it doesn't matter if it's rehab or training or competition. The specific adaptation to impose demands doesn't matter if all you're doing is training or playing or rehabbing. You're going to adapt to what is put in front of you. And these are the primary things that need to be understood, is that most of these principles are going to be exactly the same completely across the spectrum. We also have to understand that there are some specific, levels of adaptation that we need to know are available to these athletes, so that we are able to progress as we go. And this is really something that I've kind of prided myself on, is being able to take a step back and take away and look at the less is more, I hate that term, but it's kind of what it is, idea. And it's really all thanks to the fact that I've had the privilege of learning from some of the most amazing minds in the field. And when you hear people like Dr. Michael Yesis, Hank Krusenhoff, Dr. Vukoshensky, and they're all talking about the same idea of giving people as much as they need to train to get the adaptation, and not providing them a stimulus to the point that is what they can handle, then, it all kind of comes full circle, and you understand that, maybe doing less is going to allow us to do more in the long run. And now, I know exactly what you're thinking, and I can hear you screaming from across the world down there, whether you're in Australia or New Zealand or in England or California, oh shit, here we go, another 1x20 conversation. And that's not what this is going to be, all right? Although I truly do feel and have seen that there are some fantastic results following Dr. Yesis's one-set protocol and tying that in with Dr. Vukoshensky's jumping progression, that's not the goal of this talk. What the goal of this talk is to do is to actually break down where I see this minimal dose and what it actually means, and how we can better implement it and better progress it as coaches, so that, we can keep things moving forward and just kind of disseminate these misconceptions.